What is going up, guys? Welcome back to the channel, Joaquin Corrales. And in this video, we're gonna actually implement the ways in which we could create the best retargeting audiences on using Facebook ads. So in my last video, or two videos ago, I'm gonna link it somewhere up here, I showed you guys what were the best ways to retarget people on Facebook and the idea behind why it was so effective to do it that way. I had a couple people in that video ask me how those audiences are actually created. So I'm actually going to show you guys in this video how to create those three different audiences. Okay, I have them written down here. So it's targeting your email list. How do you create an audience that allows you to target your email list? Number two is retargeting your visitors. And number three is targeting people that have completed certain actions but not others. Like, for example, someone that signed up to a webinar but did not attend the actual webinar. Someone that added a product to their cart but did not end up purchasing it, right? Someone that saw a product but ended up not buying it. How do you create these custom audiences in which we're then able to start releasing or start pushing different advertisements to it? Okay, I'm gonna create another video later on in which I show you guys how to use these audiences and what type of ads you need to create in order for it to be as effective as possible. But this video, we're gonna keep it quick and I'm gonna show you guys how to create those custom audiences, because I had a couple of people in that last video ask me how to do it. And once you guys get the hang of creating these custom audiences, it's really gonna open the world as to all the different audiences that you're going to be able to create. But these are the top three most effective, in my opinion, based on all the tests and all the amount of money that we've put into it. If you guys wanna know why they're so effective, go ahead and watch the other video. This is really part two to that video. And no one watches part two first, so you need to go back. Okay, so part one, how do you bring in your email list? So obviously what you want to do is you want to come into your Facebook ad account and you want to come into the audiences section. Okay, once you're in the audiences section, you're going to see your past audiences here. But what we're going to do is we're going to hit on create audience and hit custom audience. Okay, and then after that, we're going to hit customer file. And then after that, we're gonna hit add customers from your own file or copy and paste data. You could also import it from MailChimp. But usually what I've done with, like for example, if you guys use ContactFlow, which is my email marketing software, you're able to, from the actual software, send your contacts, your leads to Facebook. But if you don't use ContactFlow for some reason for your email marketing, then you would have to export it, or you could do it through MailChimp here. And then what I would do is I would export it if I was you guys, and then I would click on add customers from your own file. And then what you guys are gonna notice is that there's a whole bunch of different fields up here. The more data that you give Facebook, the better, because what Facebook is going to do after you give it, the email is the minimum, right? The minimum that you could give Facebook is gonna be the email, and that's more than likely gonna be what you guys have if you're bringing in past customers or past leads or something. You're gonna have their email or maybe their phone number. Maybe you're doing this against a brick and mortar business and you have customers' phone numbers and you want to run ads to them. So phone number and email, I think, are gonna be the main two that are gonna allow Facebook to connect that data to an actual profile, because at the end of the day, that's what's going to happen, okay? Facebook is going to connect the emails and the phone numbers that you put in here to an actual Facebook user. And then once you start running advertisements to those people, then it's going to obviously show it to them, right? So what I do here is that I click on upload file, and then I'm gonna load up here a sample file that I have called emails. And all this emails file has is a couple of emails and in a CSV format. So your file needs to be in a CSV format or a TXT file, like it says right there. And now I'm gonna hit next, okay? I'm gonna name my audience here, so emails test. Then I'm gonna hit next. Why is my mouse lagging? Hit next, and then it's going to say, okay, here are these emails. You're gonna map this to the field that is email, and then you would also map the other ones. Like if you brought in the first name, the last name, and you guys should bring in as much info as possible because it helps Facebook in linking that up to the person. I'm gonna click upload and create, and it's gonna have pushed those two contacts. In this case, it's two. In other cases, it's 10,000, 20,000. It depends how many you're bringing in. And it's recommended that you bring in more than 100, because if it's less than 100, then for example, you can't create like a lookalike audience, which is the next step in what we would more than likely do. But let's say it's like 50 or 20 or 30 and you want to run ads to these people, you could load it on there too, and you'll be able to do that. So you're going to click on done. It's going to say updating audience, and then it's going to say audience too small. So when you guys refresh this page a couple times, it's going to say like audience too small. That doesn't really mean that the audience is too small. although it might stay like that, maybe your audience is too small, it will say that sometimes, but when you refresh the page, it'll load up to the actual number, right? So updating your audience, once this is done, this is your customer list, this is retargeting your email list right here. And then another thing that you would do, like we heard in the last video, and you guys really need to go watch that video if you haven't already. If you're still watching this and you haven't watched that, that's kind of weird. So for example, in the last video, we spoke about the idea of targeting the people in your email list who did not complete a certain action, right? And so how you would do that is that you would get a complete email list of maybe everyone in your list, and you would load it up here, right? Just to have it there, because it's good to have it here if you want to create lookalikes, if you want to target everyone else later on for something else. But what you're going to do in order to exclude people who have done certain actions is that you're going to go to your, you're going to find that list of people. So you're going to find them and put them on a file. Maybe you could export, maybe if they were signing up to a webinar, then you would export it from there. And if you have a list of 10,000 people, you're going to export those 1,000 that already signed up to the webinar. And then what you're going to do is with those 1,000 is again, load it up as another custom audience. Okay. You're going to load it up as another custom audience. So that later on in the next video where I show you guys how to run and what are the best types of advertisements to run to these retargeting campaigns, what we're going to do is that we're going to include the 10,000 and exclude the 1,000 that already signed up. Okay. And that's going to be extremely effective because you guys are not going to have to spend money showing advertisements to people who have already completed that specific action. And obviously there are also a couple of different ways to do it. Like for example, your Facebook pixel could track a custom action. And so you could do something like these 10,000 people and people who have not completed like this certain action. You could do something like that. But how I usually do it, which is really straightforward, is I'll load up the 10,000 emails and then I'll load up the 1,000 that already completed a certain action. And then I'll exclude them in the other side. And maybe that's a little bit confusing if you're more of a beginner, not a big deal. In our next video, which I'm going to create in a couple of days, I'm going to show you guys exactly how to run those ads. This video is on how to create these custom audiences. So the second type of audience that you want to create are visitors to your website. And this was extremely, extremely effective for us, targeting people who had already seen our brand, who already knew who we were, and putting advertisements in front of them from a brand that they now knew. And so they converted for a lot lower of a price, which is great for us, right? So how you do that is you come here to the first thing that you need to do in order to create this audience is that you need to have the Facebook pixel installed. And once you have the Facebook pixel installed, then you're basically set because Facebook, like I said in the last video, is going to start recording every single person that touches that website. And you're going to be able to create a custom audience, which is what the next step is. So make sure you have your Facebook pixel connected. If anyone does not know how to connect the Facebook pixel, hit me up in the comments or search up another YouTube video. I don't have one about it yet. I will make one later on what I think is the best way to do that and the strategies that go along with it. But there are tons of videos out there on how to create, how to link up a Facebook pixel and how to create it. It's extremely easy. After you have the Facebook pixel created, we're going to hit on custom audience. And then we're going to do website traffic. Okay. Now it's not customer file. Now it's website traffic. And the default version, the default action here is all website visitors. Usually I'll do in the past 180 days, right? Because if you hover here, it says, the maximum is 180 days. So I'll leave it there. And then I'll create I'll set an audience name. So visitors, and then I'll just hit create. And that's going to create another custom audience, which is this audience is extremely effective for us. I cannot stress how effective it is. And you guys literally need to try this like today. So custom audience to visitors of your website. And the cool thing about this is that later on, you're going to be able to create a lookalike to it. So people that are similar to people that came to your website. And this audience is specifically, I guess, more powerful potentially than the customer list, but in another sense, not more powerful. That's the wrong term. More dynamic, right? And what that means is that the customer list is not going to update itself, right? Because you got a list of 10,000 people and you put it in there. It's not going to keep refreshing, right? Because it's not connected to your email provider unless you're using ContactFlow. And but the visitors is a bit different because it's actually really dynamic in the sense that we just created this audience right here of people that have visited our website, but it's going to automatically refresh based on the new people that visit your website. So that's extremely powerful because you created it right now, right? It's Monday, 7:31 p.m. Christmas. Merry Christmas to everyone watching. Thanks for watching my videos on Christmas. Perfect use of your time. 7:31 Monday. And tomorrow, right, there are going to be more visitors to your website. That's okay. You don't need to create another custom audience. That audience is going to keep refreshing itself. So that's awesome. And the last audience that I want to show you guys how to create is completed certain actions but did not complete others. And this is awesome. This has been extremely effective for driving really powerful retargeting campaigns for us, because we're able to run campaigns that, for example, someone who saw my webinar landing page but did not convert, right? Did not complete registration. So let's do that one, for example. So if I would do that, and the reason why you want to create audiences like that is because, like I said before, it's a lot cheaper for you to go after that person who already saw your page, who already knows who you are, to get them to complete the action, than it is for you to not do that and to try and get cold traffic or other people who have not been introduced to that, right? So it's a lot cheaper to retarget that person. And obviously, if it's a lot cheaper for us, then it's better, because we're able to get customers, we're able to get registrations at a much lower price. So how you do that is that you click on create audience, and then you're gonna go back to custom audience, and then you're gonna go back to website traffic. But here's the deal. What we're gonna do here is we're gonna hit this drop down, and we're gonna do people who visited specific pages. Okay, so here, what I would do here is that I would put, and you see how it says URL contains? That means that you could put a part of the URL here. Like, for example, I know that this is the ending of my Shopify webinar registration page. So I'm gonna put people who have visited a page in which the URL contains this wording, and I'm gonna do exclude, okay? So people who have visited this, and exclude people who have completed registration. So I'm actually using an inactive pixel here. Let me see if this one has more activity. Yeah, so for example, I'm gonna do everyone who's who has visited a URL that is Shopify webinar, but exclude leads, okay? And I would use complete registration. It depends how you're calculating that KPI in your advertisement. So for example, what this is doing is people who have visited the Shopify webinar but who have not triggered the lead, okay? And how this works, and it also has to do with how you set up your funnel, I guess, is that you have to make sure that your Facebook pixel triggers the lead command in the thank you page. So in the thank you page of my webinar, after you sign up, it actually triggers a complete registration, which is the equivalent of a lead. They're just different names, but they kind of mean the same. It depends on what you're targeting. So a complete registration. So what I would do is people who have visited Shopify webinar, but people who have not, or exclude people who have completed registration. And that's really gonna allow me to drive some very powerful campaigns, because now I could put an advertisement in front of that person that's like, hey, I know that you're interested in our webinar. I also noticed that you didn't attend. These are the results of people who are attending this webinar, so and so. And guys, just a point real quick. I have a complete video over 50 minutes long, I think a little bit less than an hour long, on everything about Facebook ads if you're a beginner. So if you're a beginner, you have no idea what it is that I'm talking about, hit that video. It's gonna be in the description. Check that out, and then check part one, because this is part two. If you have not watched part one and you're part two, you're weird. And then come watch this video, right, which is part two. And there's also a part three coming out and whatever. And remember, this is how you do this one. A person completed a certain action but did not complete another. Let's do another example of this. Okay, so let's say a person that saw a product but did not add it to cart. Okay, these are the type of people that you need to keep showing this product, because they already went to your page to see it. They're interested in it. Obviously, if not, they wouldn't have clicked on it. So how can you keep showing this person this product so that they finally add it to cart, so that they finally purchase? And it's the same train of thought that we just followed. So you would go to website traffic, and then you would do people who visited specific pages. Here you would put your product. So for example, kitchen utensil. Let's say you're selling kitchen utensils, and I'm gonna exclude, right? Or not exclude, this time it's include. And also, so I would hit and also, no, not URL. So include more. So I would hit include more. Actually no, because this is an or. So up here, you would have to switch to all, and then you would have to do further narrow. See how this switched to an and right here in the middle? That's perfect. So people who have visited this specific page and have, let me switch up the, your pixel is gonna have more actions. Obviously, if it's connected, I'm using an inactive pixel here. That's why it's not showing a lot of stuff. So people who have visited a page that contains kitchen utensil and who have, I think we said not added to cart, right? Yeah, so this is how you do an and. So for example, people have visited this and added to cart, and then you could do like, but hasn't purchased, right? It's very logical. But let's go back to what I said I was going to do. I just lost that train of thought. And it was people that have visited a page of a kitchen utensil, but have not added to cart, right? There you go. So people have visited that page but have not added that specific item to cart. And this is extremely, extremely powerful, the way that you're able to create these audiences and create these different campaigns in which you're able to retarget these people. And obviously, there's a lot more that goes to it. Like, for example, if you have a lot more, if you have a lot of products in your page, then you're going to have to link a specific action to it, because if they have added another product to their cart potentially. But this is just the basic idea behind it and how you create these really powerful retargeting audiences. Now, the reason why they're so, so important, and it may be obvious to some of you, maybe it's not for others, you're going to see in part one of this video, hit somewhere up here to watch that. Hope you didn't get to the end of this and now you're going to go watch it. But guys, I'll see you on the next one. Thanks for watching this. Merry Christmas. And we're doing a 180-day video challenge. So we're releasing a video every single day, no days off. It's Christmas. I'm here recording. The family's outside. I'm about to go out there. And I'll see you tomorrow on the next one.